Welcome back to the channel, guys. Welcome back to the vlog. And I hope you saw the last video where I drove the BMW M5 F10 and I compared it every which way to my E60 M5. Today's video, we're going to continue on that path and we're going to talk about the E60 M5 versus the F10 M5. And we're going to talk about specific problems that these cars have, chronic issues, consistent problems that owners are finding with these cars. A lot of the issues you know on the E60, and we'll make comparison to the F10, so we're really going to hone in on the F10 issues, and I really hope you enjoy it. Stick around, let's get to it. So firstly, let's focus in on the issues that are found typically, or there have been many complaints around the F10 M5. The first one is oil consumption. There's been reports that numerous owners have reported oil consumption as bad as 1 quart per 500-600 miles. There's been also people that have said they don't fill up oil or they haven't had to add a quart until 15,000 miles. And there's been many reports anywhere in between. Lots of reports that would suggest a quart every 1,000, every 2,000 miles. That's a very common complaint, which is quite excessive by a lot of standards. Now, comparing that to the E60, that's a very similar concept. The E60 wasn't without oil consumption. We won't talk about the rod bearings per se. Oil consumption related, the E60 also had a very comparable number. A lot of the E60 cars generally use oil, maybe a quart per 1,500 miles, 2,000 miles, even as bad as 1,000 miles per liter used, or quart used. Now, what causes this oil consumption? Well, it's a pretty common fact and knowledge that a lot of the M cars actually consume oil, and they consume oil at a very high rate. Unfortunately, a lot more so than most other cars. Well, what causes this? Well, some of it's the very nature of the car and the design. They know that they're typically high revving cars, so often BMW designs tolerances slightly larger than you would normally find in a slow, weak, gutless street car. A lot of the M cars are designed with slightly looser tolerances because of their high revving nature. They were actually engineered that way. Also, another big part of it, a big part of what's happening with oil consumption has to do, and this is consistent with both cars by the way, has to do with the way the car was broken in. How can you fix that issue? You can't if you're buying the car used. How can you fix it new? Well, the best way, of course, is following the directions by the manufacturer, and that is proper break-in technique. That's not over-revving it, that's not bogging it down, that is strictly driving it at varying speeds, under different loads, and basically changing your RPM frequently. You don't want to hold RPM for too long of a time at any RPM. That will not properly seat the engine, and this can result in excessive oil consumption down the road. Another issue commonly found in a lot of the F10 M5s has to do with overheating. Is it a serious problem? Well, really only if you overheat the engine too far to the point where you get warpage in the heads or the engine itself, you can have a substantial issue and possibly an engine failure outright if you let it overheat. What causes this overheating issue? Well, the overheating issue in this case, in most cases, has to do with the electric water pump. These cars have an electric water pump, and often there's a module that drives that or any of the electrical circuitry that motivates that pump if they fail, and they have failed, causing overheating conditions. This coincidentally doesn't seem to be too much of an issue with the E60s, which there are not a lot of reports with the E60 cars having significant overheating conditions. The next issue has to do in the F10 with a drivetrain failure. DTM failure, drivetrain failure, is a very common failure in the F10s. Why? Well, first of all, let's start by saying it's a big nuisance for owners. A lot of people are getting very frustrated with that issue. And some people get this issue over and over. A vast repeating of this problem seems to afflict a lot of cars out there. And what is really causing that problem? There's a variety of reasons that causes that failure. One of them has to do with under the conditions, it seems that a lot of drivers are driving these cars very hard when they get that code. A lot of them are hitting either the red line or the governor. So they're pushing the car to the top limits of its potential or its capability. So the tracing the roots back, lots of these issues are attributed to possibly reduction or not adequate injector, fuel injector flow to support the horsepower output. Some of it has to do with cam timing that is not quite off, or the vano system that doesn't put the cam in the right position. The cam's out of sync, that'll spit out that code. That is a very common problem afflicted in these cars. Now the E60, on the other hand, doesn't particularly have this code, although it has its own limp mode of sorts, and the E60 has a code that is often driven by one of two things: idle actuators or throttle actuators. Those are the two things that are commonly afflicting the E60 M5. So the next issue that a lot of F10 owners complain about has to do with the transmission. And the transmission, of course, in this car is either a manual six-speed transmission, or primarily comes standard with a double clutch transmission, DCT. Versus the E60's car utilizes the latest and the greatest of the SMG variety called the SMG3. The SMG is essentially a single disc automated. It basically engages, disengages. It operates more or less like a standard transmission, and in a lot of cases, it acts like a weak, poor driving driver who's just learning to drive a manual transmission. In other words, it's very lurchy and slinky, and when it's dialed into its basic settings or default settings, it's quite, gross. It actually turns up very nicely when you decide to actually use it in the higher speed, the S5s, the S6 settings. Then it becomes, falls into its own. The DCT, there's been complaints that it's very jerky, and people have complained that there's sudden acceleration or sudden jerkiness or deceleration, it gives you a snap. And a lot of owners have complained that this is a problem. Some of it might be legitimate, but the reality is when you dial the speed settings of the transmission on the F10, there's the S1, 2, and 3. If you set the DCT up to S3, that is the hardest, most aggressive shift setting for the double clutch transmission. And trust me when I say, it is a very hard, very abrupt change. Especially if you're downshifting, it kind of does, snaps you quite hard and quite aggressively. And upshift as well, it's a very hard driveline shutter, if you will. Maybe not a shutter, but certainly a shock on the system. So I know a lot of owners have complained about that. A lot of it, largely I would say, is a normal characteristic of the DCT transmission, whereas the SMG tends to drive more of a slower, sloppier shifting. The DCT is more abrupt and more hits more definitively. So they're quite different by nature. Their overall performance is quite different, and I think for a lot of people, it is a different driving mechanism, and it takes people by surprise. That being said, of course, there are issues, and it's a mechanical device, and it's not that there can't be failures. Of course there can. There's also been reports on the clutches wearing out and other related problems like that over time, or hard driving or abuse. But generally speaking, they are very snappy and aggressive. So another problem reported by F10 owners has to do with engine rattling noises. Now, generally speaking, these engines are very quiet, they're dialed in, they're very nice engines, they run nice, they're crisp, it's a BMW product, pretty typical. Sometimes where these rattling noises come from are the vanos, and it's the same issue that you typically find in the E60s. It's the variable valve timing system that starts to make noise. It's a mechanical device that's operating your camshaft timing, of course. And with time, they start to make a little bit of noise, they rattle. There's also a problem if the oil starts to leak, you can have leakage and they don't react the way they should. So the vano systems themselves can cause a problem, they can certainly make noise, and that's another complaint of the F10 owners. Not too unlike the E60 owners, they also have a similar problem too. And the last problem that is commonly known by F10 owners is steering vibration, a shaking or a humming sensation coming from the front wheels. A lot of owners have tried to, it's been elusive. A lot of people don't even have a clue. There's no issue with a lot of these cars, but some owners are commenting that this is a problem. Even after taking the car back to the dealer for numerous tire balances, inspections, it doesn't really expose a lot of issues. Some of the things that were attributed though were, over time, a flaw in some of the 19-inch wheels showed a slight crease on the inside and outside rim edge of the 19-inch wheels, as I mentioned. That was enough to throw the balance up just a hair to even give you a slight shake. Don't forget too, a lot of the tires that go on these cars are very sticky, and some hard turns, some aggressive braking maneuvers, and it doesn't take much to shave trim a piece off of a tire that can translate, of course, into vibration issues. Everybody, I hope you enjoyed the video. Many of these issues are not uncommon to both cars, of course. The one that stands out for the E60 is the rod bearings, whereas the F10 doesn't typically have a lot of the rod bearing issues. The F10, however, has more issues around overheating and vibrations in the front suspension. So everybody, hope you enjoyed the video. As always, make sure you give my channel a like. Don't forget to drop a comment. And of course, subscribe to the channel. Love to see you in the next one. See you soon. Bye-bye.